welcome to Medicine Hat's premier studio gym, Temple Fitness.
You walk in here saying, I'm going to work as hard as I can today.
Our personal trainers, Shane and Melissa, believe that fitness is a lifestyle, and your body is the temple that lives it. You're watching ComTV's Temple Fitness Challenge. This week at Temple Fitness, Brian and Joey brave the cold in a special outdoor workout Shane has prepared just for them.
Because we're going outside. We're going out in the great Canadian winter. This is a Canadian warrior workout, and apparently Shane thinks we're ready for it, so.
Okay, now take big steps walking back and forth. You're creating your own path, guys. This is the path you're going to work out on, so try and bring it down as much as possible.
It's an opportunity to mix it up. Plus, you get to work out in the fresh air, and it feels good. You get the sun shining on you. Middle of January, end of January, people start to feel what's called the winter blues. Some people even suffer from seasonal affective disorder. So this is just an opportunity to come outside and eat in the fresh air and the sun, feel a little better, have a lot of fun, get the fresh air. It even works your lungs a little more because the cold air makes it a little bit harder to breathe. So it's just something different, a little more fun. Well, let's go.
Alrighty. Do it.
Okay, jog there and back again.
Oh.
So one of the benefits of working out outside, because the ground is so uneven, keep going guys, back and forth. Because the ground is so uneven, it forces your ankles and knees to stabilize yourself. So it's a little bit harder, it seems harder, than it would be on a treadmill. You may run 5 kilometers here and 5 kilometers on a treadmill. It's going to seem a lot harder here because the ground is very, very uneven. So you're stabilizing as well as running.
Okay, guys, so we're going to just sprint there and back. Now what we do, we sprint there and back, we come back, we get no more than a 5 second break, 5 second maximum. Just enough to take 2 really deep breaths, sprint there again. Come back, 2 deep breaths. So five of those. Let's go.
Shane always has a great reason to justify his challenging workouts.
Plus, because the snow has a bit of give to it, you have to push off a little bit harder. So every single step is a little bit harder. So if you think you're even pushing 1 pound per every single step, over the course of 500 steps, you've now pressed 500 pounds. So it makes a huge difference.
Okay, guys, come on in.
Okay, guys, just real quick here. When working out outside, you want to make sure of a couple things. Try to, as much as possible, breathe through your nose, because your nose filters and warms cold air, so it won't seem as hard on your lungs. You also want to make sure that you're dressed in layers. A layer that has trapped warm air inside is great. Plus, with layers, you can take off clothes as you get warm and things like that. Most importantly, though, is hydration. You want to make sure you're well hydrated. If you're dry out here, the cold air is really going to make it that much harder. You're going to feel fatigued a lot quicker.
Okay.
We're good with that? Well, you will find because the air is colder, it makes it a little bit harder to breathe. You'll fatigue a lot quicker. So you want to make sure that you're gauging yourself, but still go as hard, push yourself as hard as you would indoors. Just be aware that you're probably going to tire out a little bit quicker. So when you start to feel tired, same as when you start to feel tired inside, slow down and take a bit of a break. You just realize it'll probably come a little bit sooner than normal.
Well, obviously the ground isn't flat. There's all kinds of little icy things, and it sort of keeps you on your game. It's like almost like you have to think while you're walking, eh?
In through the nose if possible. Yeah, on your own time, just 2 deep breaths and go again.
Hustle back, hustle.
And good. Grab a drink, guys. Tired?
The natural inclination is to just lean over and do this and catch your breath.
And while that may seem more comfortable, what you're actually doing is you're compressing your lungs. So there's no way I can take a full breath if I'm bent over. If you need to, lean up against a wall, get your hands up over your head. That opens up your chest, opens up your lungs, helps you breathe a little better. You also want to breathe in through your nose.
Impossible.
Hold it out through your mouth. That way you can take a full breath that way.
Yeah. Oh, man.
Okay. 2 feet leave, 2 feet land. Joey, get in there. Take a break. You need to, but finish this. 2 feet leave, 2 feet land.
Oh, I see.
Yeah, so like this, you're going for 2 feet, landing on 2 feet.
Okay.
Every time. You want to make sure your ankles and knees absorb the shock. Your back is not a shock absorber, guys.
It's cold out here.
It's harder to breathe outside?
Oh yeah. It's like trying to climb a mountain.
Don't bend over.
Oh, yeah.
But I have to admit, though, the cold really does help when you're sweating your ass off.
You want more in you, Brian? There you go. There you go. Joey, you got the last one in you? Give yourself one more.
I can barely see.
Seeing is overrated.
Fine.
Guys, we're done in 5 minutes. Give yourself 5 more minutes of hard work and we're done. No more sprints after this, Brian. There you go. Let's make a new track. Get out of your track. Make a new one. Good. That's a huge benefit of working out outside. It can always be different. If you go to a gym, a traditional gym, where they have just the same equipment every day, you're only going to be able to do really the same workouts every day. You come outside, he moves over 2 inches, he's got a whole new track of snow right there. It's just so many options outside. Outside, your body is just trying to keep warm.
Yeah.
Now when you come back inside from training out in the cold weather, your body won't react immediately. So it's still in the mode of trying to keep warm.
Yeah.
Now you're going to start sweating less.
Yeah.
So you want to make sure that you cool down properly when you come in from outside. So we're going to head over there and do a bit of a cool down, guys.
Excellent. That sounds good.
These fitness tips are brought to you by Shane and Melissa at Temple Fitness, 1910 11th Avenue Northwest in Briar Park.